You know that finding fun and engaging ways to help your students prepare for state testing can be a challenge. And let's face it, you don't want to teach to the test, but at the same time, you know it's crucial to provide students with opportunities so that they can be successful on standardized testing. So with a little creativity, using this one activity that I'm going to walk you through, preparing for the state test can be both fun and effective at the same time. And that is where a test prep treasure hunt comes in. So a treasure hunt might sound a bit daunting. You're like, I don't really want to do that. But I promise putting in just a little bit of prep work up front is going to be so worth it when you see how engaging and effective this activity can be. Plus, this is one of those things that you can use year after year once you create it. You create it once and that's it. Before we continue though, be sure to hit subscribe where you're watching this video for more like this one. All right, here's what you'll need in order to set up your test prep treasure hunt. That's so hard for me to say for some reason. All right, you're gonna find some short reading passages in your ELA textbook. You're gonna look in your novel or short story, whatever it is that your class is reading. You can even look in some nonfiction articles if you want to. And then you're gonna come up with 4 to 5 multiple choice questions about each passage. You wanna make sure to use things like direction words that are common on state tests so that students are internalizing what those words mean. And I wanna give you a quick time-saving hack. So if you're finding passages from your textbook or a novel unit that you already have in place, I suggest that you see if there are any questions included in the curriculum that you can just tweak a little bit by adding in a common direction word. And a little side note, if you haven't checked out the first video in our series all about test prep, it's called Expert Tips for Getting Your Students to Ace Their Multiple Choice Tests. Make sure that you take the time to watch that one where we dive deep into an activity with direction words so that your students actually understand what test questions are asking them, right? And I wanna give you a quick reminder of some of the most common direction words that students might find in test questions before we start to dive more into this activity. So these are common direction words. Things like analyze, explain, illustrate, compare, contrast, interpret, summarize, demonstrate, indicate, infer, describe, support, define, and convey. And if you're watching this on our YouTube channel, you can just take a screenshot of that video or that part of the screen so you can show that with your students. All right, so let's look at a sample of a passage along with some corresponding questions and answers that you might create for your test prep treasure hunt. This passage that I'm going to share with you is all about an actual treasure hunt and the mystery surrounding Oak Island in Nova Scotia. So again, remember, you can find pre-written passages from your existing curriculum to cut down on your prep time. So if we look at the very first question, it states the following. Which of the following options best summarizes the passage? The second one is, what of the following best explains the purpose of the footnote in this passage? Number 3, which of the following quotes from the passage does not support the idea that the history of Oak Island is uncertain? And then the last one, which of the following options best describes Daniel McGinnis as he is portrayed in this passage? Now I want you to notice that the questions in this sample contain direction words like summarizes or explains or supports or describes. So when you create your questions for each passage, you're going to write the title of the passage at the top of the page, and you'll also want to put each set of questions on its own piece of paper. So two different things, right? You'll be giving copies of those questions to groups of students to answer during the treasure hunt. Once you have a few short reading passages and the corresponding questions, you're ready for the next step. So on the day of your treasure hunt, you will hide a copy of each reading passage around your classroom. And it's up to you how difficult you want to make this, right? You can put it under chairs, on the side of the recycling bin. You can be as creative as you want. And if you want to add like a little extra fun, you can also hide pieces of paper around the room with silly instructions for students to find. And this is fun and just brings a little levity to your classroom. So for example, one of those pieces of paper might say, when you find this paper, call out for the class to hear, we found the treasure. Or another paper might tell students, keep looking, nothing to find here. So things like that to create just a little bit more fun. Additional papers can have the test-taking strategies that students can read or a review of direction words and their definitions. So you can be as creative as you want with this optional part if you want to add some extra excitement or extra review to this activity. When you're ready to begin the treasure hunt, divide your class into small groups, ideally no more than like 3 students per group, so really small groups. Give each group copies of the pages with all of the questions that you created. Then you're going to instruct students to quietly and discreetly walk around your classroom. They must thoughtfully read and follow the instructions on any treasure hunt paper that they come across that's hidden in the room. Now, a quick teacher hack here, you may want to copy all of the reading passages and those optional fun and review papers I just described on certain colored paper. Then you can tell the class that they're searching for like 10 yellow or 10 purple pieces of paper or whatever color works for your activity. Then explain to students that if they come across a reading passage, they get to read it quietly in their group and answer the corresponding questions on the question sheets that you passed out to them. Students should not remove any of the passages from their hidden locations. Their goal is to find all of the quote unquote buried treasure and not share locations or answers with other groups. You may also consider giving something like a small prize, sticker, candy, whatever your students respond to groups who get enough answers correct. Also think carefully of the number you expect from your group, right? If your class is advanced, you may want to require all correct answers in order for a prize. Well, if your class needs a lot of practice, you may want to require a certain just number of, you know, fewer correct responses. Totally up to you. This test prep treasure hunt is a great way to review direction words, which will help boost students' test scores. This is guaranteed your students will be begging for more treasure hunts and actually enjoying test prep. All right, in the final video of the test prep series, which releases next week, we'll be walking you through ways to use your existing curriculum to prepare your students for state testing. Get ready for some effective lesson ideas that your students will enjoy and that won't take you hours to create.